Oh, Stand. And let me stand, my faith on heaven. this morning. Hallelujah. First Corinthians chapter 15 from verse 54 and 55. I read. So when this corruptible shall be put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. 55. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? Hallelujah. Our Father and our Lord, we want to thank you this morning because you have risen. And for this cause, that is why we are standing here today, to declare and proclaim that you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We thank you for this opportunity to fellowship with you today. We give you the praise and adoration because you rule and reign in the affairs of men. We thank you because you have conquered death. You have risen. And that is why we are standing here today, to say you are God. You are King. You are our Savior and our Redeemer. Lord, we give you praise. We give you all the glory and all the honor. We magnify your holy name today in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, we call down your presence, that you will take charge and full preeminence today in the name of Jesus Christ. We ask, O Lord, that everything we do today be unto your own glory in the name of Jesus Christ. And we nullify every works of darkness, and we pull down every stronghold in the name of Jesus Christ. And we ask, O Lord, that every vessel you have prepared today for your own glory, Father, may you sanctify, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we ask, O Lord, that you take charge, that you disrupt our plans today, that you disrupt our programs today, and may your presence and your spirit take charge and flow in our midst, in the name of Jesus Christ. May hearts be touched today, may healings take place today, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because of your resurrection, may things begin to change in the atmosphere and in our lives and in our spirit man, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you, O God, because you always hear us, and we pray, O God, that at the end of the day we'll have our cause to glorify your name, because you have been with us. Be thou exalted, be thou glorified, be thou lifted up, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Hallelujah, everybody. Hallelujah, everyone.
Hallelujah.
Come and make some joyful noise in the house. Are you happy to be here? Happy resurrection morning to you. Woo! Happy Easter to you. Come on, say to your neighbor, happy resurrection morning to you. Are you ready to celebrate Jesus? He's alive. The tomb is empty. Somebody celebrate Jesus. Come on, make some noise. Hallelujah. Hey. One more time we say, I will praise all the time. Praises shall continually be in my mouth. Say, I will praise
all the time. His praises shall continually be in my mouth.
One more time, say, I will praise
all the time.
His praises shall continually be in my mouth. Say, I will praise
all the time.
Say,
His praises shall continually be in my mouth.
Oh, we say, praise God, deserve praise. great praise, cause it's greater than everything. Oh, great God is our great praise, cause it's greater than everything.
It's a great God.
Great God is our great praise, cause it's greater than everything.
Great God is our great praise, cause it's greater than everything.
Somebody make some joyful noise in this place.
Ba-da-ba, ba-da-ba.
We pray,
I'm praying
all the time,
all the time. His praises shall continually be in my mouth.
Say how we pray,
I'm praying
all the time,
all the time. His praises shall continually be in my mouth.
Say great God,
great God is our great praise, cause it's greater than everything.
Somebody give him a shout of praise. Hallelujah. Hey, listen. I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what comes my way. The greater one lives inside of me. His name is Jesus. I'm born a winner, more than victorious. I'm the head of his kingdom.
Here with the Holy Ghost.
Here with the Holy Ghost. I'm gonna dance and praise him. It doesn't matter what comes my way. The greater one lives inside of me. What's his name?
His name is Jesus.
I'm born
a winner,
more than victorious.
More than victorious.
I'm the head. I rejoice in him. Somebody rejoice. Jump for joy.
More than a conqueror.
I rejoice in him.
I'm more than a conqueror.
No weapon formed against me shall never prosper. Greater one lives inside of me.
His name is Jesus.
I'm born a winner.
More than victorious.
I'm the head.
I'm the head of his kingdom.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
No weapon
formed against me
shall never prosper.
Hey,
greater one lives inside.
You're
of
not
me.
Singing it. His name is Jesus.
No weapons shall never prosper.
The greater one lives inside of me. What's his name?
His name is Jesus.
I'm born a winner.
More than victorious.
I'm the head.
I'm the head of his kingdom.
Filled with the Holy Ghost.
More than victorious.
victorious.
More than victorious.
Rejoice.
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 Somebody rejoice.
Rejoice.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
Rejoice.
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 More than victorious.
More than victorious.
More than a conqueror.
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 Rejoice.
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 More than a conqueror.
Somebody celebrate Jesus. Come on. Get your dance on now. Put your hands together like you know God. If you know that the Lion of the Judah has prevailed for you, open up your mouth and make some joyful noise.
Hallelujah.
So rejoice.
Rejoice.
So rejoice. More than a conqueror.
More than a conqueror.
So rejoice.
Rejoice.
Even in the darkest time, rejoice.
Rejoice.
Always rejoice.
Rejoice.
Say, more than a conqueror.
More than a conqueror.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
Say, more than victorious.
More than victorious.
Say, more than victorious.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
More than victorious.
Say, more than a conqueror.
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 Celebrate Jesus. Hey, hallelujah. Listen. Celebrate Jesus. Celebrate. Hey. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. I can't hear you say. Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. Woo! Celebrate Jesus, celebrate. Everybody, come on, open up your mind and say.
Celebrate Jesus, celebrate.
Everybody, come on, say.
Celebrate Jesus, celebrate.
One more time, everybody say celebrate.
Celebrate, Jesus, celebrate.
Hey,
celebrate.
Now we're gonna do
celebrate.
We're gonna do something real fun right now. You ready? Now all the ladies in the house, make some joyful noise. Hallelujah. Oh daughter of Zion, make some joyful noise. Now you're gonna go for us. I want to hear your voice, alright? Are you ready? We go. Celebrate, Jesus, celebrate. Come on, daughter of Zion. You go. I can't hear you. One more time. Louder. Say. Ah, what are you going to do this morning? Celebrate. All the men in the house, are you ready? Celebrate.
Celebrate, Jesus, celebrate.
Say celebrate.
Celebrate.
I can't hear you.
Celebrate.
With a joy of God in your heart. Celebrate.
Celebrate. Jesus, celebrate.
Say celebrate.
Celebrate.
Everybody, are you ready? Open up your mouth. Say celebrate.
Celebrate. Jesus, celebrate.
Say celebrate.
Celebrate. Jesus, celebrate.
He is risen. Say, he is risen.
He is risen. And he lives
forevermore.
Forevermore.
He is
risen.
He is risen.
Risen.
Say,
come on and celebrate.
Hey,
come on and celebrate.
Oh, oh.
The resurrection of our Lord.
Come on and celebrate.
Come on and celebrate.
The resurrection of our resurrection of our Lord. Everybody say, we're gonna celebrate.
We're gonna celebrate.
Yes, we will.
We're gonna celebrate
the resurrection.
The resurrection of our Lord.
One more time with a loud voice, say, we're gonna celebrate.
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 So we're gonna celebrate.
We're gonna celebrate.
So we're gonna celebrate.
We're gonna celebrate.
We're gonna jump for joy.
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 We're gonna shout a praise.
We're gonna shout a
praise.
We're gonna shout a praise.
We're gonna celebrate.
We're gonna shout a praise.
We're gonna celebrate.
We're gonna celebrate
the resurrection.
The resurrection of our Lord.
Hello. Somebody make some joyful noise in the house. Is that the best you can do? Make some joyful noise in the house. Let your hallelujah be louder than your neighbor. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know and you know it, hallelujah, and you believe it, that the Lion of the Judah, the tribe of Judah, hallelujah, has prevailed for you, come and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know that for you, he came, he died, and he rose again, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know that for your sake he became poor that you might be rich in him, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you know that the Son of God became sin that you might be the righteousness of God, shout hallelujah. We give you glory, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are God of all the earth. You are God of all the earth. We sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. You are God.
You are God of all the earth.
Hallelujah.
You have won the victory.
Come on, raise your voice in this place. Everybody say yes. Hallelujah. Come on, lift it up, lift it up.
Yeah.
You have won it all.
You have won it all for me.
One more time with our instrument. We sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, lift it up in this place.
Yeah.
You have won it.
You have won the victory.
Sing it to him. Sing hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you believe it, sing it with everything you have. Say,
you have won it all for me.
Death could not shed.
Death could not hold you.
The reason, say,
you are the reason, King.
Seated in majesty,
seated in majesty.
You are the reason, King, say,
you are the reason,
by his stripes we were healed, by the nail-pierced sins we're free, by his blood
we have the victory. Jesus overcame it all. Oh, yes, he does. Oh, he has won our freedom. Jesus has won it all.
Come on, everybody, with your hands lifted high. Say hallelujah, hallelujah. Say, say
you have won the victory. Sing hallelujah,
hallelujah.
You have won it all. Say
you have won it all for me.
Say death could not hold.
You are the reason.
Seated in majesty,
seated in majesty.
You are the reason.
You are the reason.
In few seconds, just minister to him. Is the risen King. Behold the Lamb of God who took away the sin of the world. Behold the risen Savior. In few seconds, minister to him.
Risen King, you are the risen King. The risen King, you are the risen.
Dark ones came, stole my mind, wrapped my soul in chains. Now I live among the dead, fighting voices in my head, hoping someone hears me crying in the night and carries me away. Set me free.
No crime, yet they crucified him. He died and was buried in a tomb, yet he lives today. His name is Jesus.
They scream his name. Is this the one they say will set the captive free? Jesus, rescue me. Set me free. Oh,
Praise the Lord. Let's appreciate the Lord. Amazing. Wonderful. Wonderful. Hallelujah. That was really good. Jesus paid it. Yes. Yes. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. He paid the debt. He did not hold. I hold the debt I could not pay. I needed someone to take my sins away. Now I can sing a brand new song. Hallelujah. Jesus paid the price that I could never pay. Let's sing together. He paid the debt he did not owe. I owe the debt I could not pay. I needed someone to take my sins away. Oh, I can sing a brand new song, amazing grace. One more time. Oh, he paid the debt he did not owe. I owe the debt I could not pay. I needed someone to take my sins away. But now I can sing, a brand new song. Amazing grace. Lord Jesus paid the debt I never paid. Gracious Father, we stand in awe of you this resurrection morning. We remember the event that took place over 2,000 years ago. Beginning from the time you triumphantly stepped into Jerusalem, to the point where you met with your disciples and instituted the Last Supper, from there to Gethsemane, where you agonized in prayer, asking the Father if it was possible for the cup to pass, because it was in his hand. You knew exactly what was in that cup, the iniquities of us all, and you had to drink it. Such that for a moment the Father couldn't look at the Son because of the sin that you carried upon yourself. The betrayal, the ridicule, the mockery, they slapped you and they told you to prophesy. Who slapped you? They insulted you, mocked you, but you endured it. Because of the joy that was set before you, the joy of seeing many sons and daughters come into glory. Three times you asked the Father, same question, let this cup pass over. Then you came to the conclusion, not as I will, not my will, but let your will be done. Because if you didn't go to the cross, all of us would have perished in our sins. Now we stand here We can come boldly and fearlessly, confidently before the throne of God because of the blood that you shed. We have access to the Father. We can call God our Father. And as a matter of fact, you said, go and tell my brothers that I go to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God. Scripture says you are not ashamed to call us brothers, brethren. We're grateful. We're grateful for the ultimate price, the sacrifice. Scripture says it was once and for all offering. We thank you. Thank you for the exchange that took place. Thank you for taking that place in punishment. The Bible says the chastisement for our peace was upon you. And by your stripes, we have been healed. Thank you for paying it in full. Thank you. 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 And so, Heavenly Father, this morning we ask, whatever it is that is dying, that should live. By the reason of the power that raised Jesus from the dead. Because scripture says the same power is at work in us, the quickening spirit. Lift hands that are down. Make straight that which is lame. Revive that which is dying. Restore what we have lost that is precious to us. Whatever represents grave, please open it up today. Let there be resurrection. We pray for renewal. We pray for revival. We pray for restoration. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. It is in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Let's put our hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. Before I share this morning, we'd like to rejoice with those who are celebrating birthday this month and a wedding anniversary. We want to rejoice with you. We want to say thank you to God on your behalf. If I may humbly ask, if you're here, please, if you'd like to stand just for recognition so that we know who we're praying for. If you're here and it's your month, please stand up. Let's pray for you. God bless you. And if you're watching online, we see you through the eyes of faith. We know that you're there and there's no distance in the spirit. We pray that the prayer we're offering here will also reach you there in Jesus' mighty name. So, gracious Father, we want to thank you. Thank you, Lord, for your precious children. Life is a gift from you. Because you are the giver of life and you are the sustainer of life. We thank you because it has pleased you to bring your children into a new year. Because we know that the path of a just person is like shining light that shines brighter and brighter to the perfect day. We believe strongly that this year will be better than the previous years in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray for new beginning of joy and peace in the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that God will bless you with the fullness of the blessing of heaven above. We pray that His grace will be sufficient for you for this new year and the years to come in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray that God will give you a special gift this year in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not spend this year in sorrow. You will not spend this new year in sickness. Disease will be far away from you in the name of Jesus Christ. Infirmity will be far away from you in the name of Jesus Christ. Grief will be far away from you in the name of Jesus Christ. Evil will be far away from you. We pray that as the mountains surround Jerusalem, the Lord's glory will surround you in the name of Jesus Christ. What no man can do, it will do for you. And all will be well in the name of Jesus Christ. New level of grace, new level of joy, new level of possibilities, of opportunities in the name of Jesus. New wine in your home in the name of Jesus. Joy only, no sorrow. And so shall it be. And so, gracious Father, we commend your children to you and to the word of your grace that is able to build them up and give them their inheritance. Please build them up by your word. Let your grace be sufficient for them, Heavenly Father. And we prophesy into your life that your best days and years are still ahead of you in the name of Jesus. From glory to glory, from grace to grace, from strength to strength, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for hearing, Heavenly Father. It is in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen. Let's put our hands together. God bless you. Happy birthday and happy wedding anniversary. Amen. I want to share this morning. Obviously, we began a new teaching series 2 weeks ago about the kingdom of God because it's Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday. So I'm going to stop for today to talk about the importance of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. So next week, by God's special grace, we'll continue with the teaching series on the kingdom of God. This is so very important because without the resurrection of Jesus Christ, then there is nothing to Christianity. That he died, of course, amazing. Because we know the importance of his death. But if only that he died and buried, and he did not resurrect, then what we have received is nothing different from other religion. Because if you're talking about, as a matter of fact, some people consider Jesus to be an amazing prophet. They had no problem with the fact that, yes, he's a prophet, but to believe and accept that he is the Son of God, that's is the issue. And up until this moment, some people still don't believe that Jesus resurrected. And that's the foundation of our faith. So I want us to begin, as I ask you to please turn your Bibles to Matthew chapter 27. Please, if you can have that on the screen, that would be great. Matthew 27. We're going to read from 62 to 66, and we're going to read the next chapter of 28, 1 to 6, and 11 to 15. I just want to lay a foundation. Matthew 27, 62 to 66, scripture says, on the next day, which followed the day of preparation, the chief priests and Pharisees gathered together to Pilate, saying, "Sir, we remember while he was still alive how that deceiver," they called Jesus the deceiver, "after 3 days he said, 'I will rise.'" The next verse. "Therefore, command that the tomb be made secure until the third day, lest his disciples come by night and seal him away and say to the people, he has risen from the dead, so the last deception will be worse than the first. Pilate said to them, you have a God, go your way, make it as secure as you know how. So he gave them the opportunity to just go and do whatever it is that they would like to do. And so I'm sure they went and they put the best security system in place so that his disciples, according to them, would not go there and steal his body and then tell people that he actually rose from the dead. So scripture says in verse 66, so they went and made the tomb secure, sealing the stone and setting the guard. Now, let's go to chapter 28, okay, from verse 1, thank you. Now after the Sabbath, that is Sunday, the first day of the week began to dawn. Mary Magdalene and the other Mary came to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat on it. His countenance was like lightning and his clothing as white as snow. And the guards shook for fear of him and became like dead men. But the angel answered and said to the woman, do not be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He is not here. And his disciples did not come by night to take away his body. He is not here. The tomb is empty. He said, come see the place the Lord lay. Let's jump to verse 11 to 15. And now while they were going, behold, some of the guard came into the city and reported to the chief priests all the things that had happened. When they had assembled with the elders and consulted together, they gave a large sum of money to the soldiers. So bribery didn't start today. Saying, tell them, his disciples came at night and stole away while we slept. And if this comes to the governor's ears, we will appease him and make you secure. So they took the money and did as they were instructed. And this saying, and that's where I'm going, and this saying is commonly reported among the Jews until this day. Some people couldn't believe because of this report that no, he did not rise from the dead. He did not resurrect. They actually went to the tomb. His disciples went there and they took away his body. But ladies and gentlemen, we're not trying to believe that Jesus rose from the dead. We believe that he rose from the dead. We're not trying to psych ourselves up to say, well, let's just believe and just move with the flow. No. And if that is the realm that you are operating in, then you must really talk to God to allow this to dawn on you and come to you by revelation and settle in your heart that indeed Jesus rose from the dead, because it is the foundation of what we consider to be the faith that we have received. Because when you read in Acts chapter 5, I think from verse 34, when Gamaliel, that powerful teacher of the law, said to the Sanhedrin council, leave these people alone. Because they told them not to pray in the name of Christ anymore. He said, do you remember that a man, maybe we should read Acts chapter 5, verse 34. Acts chapter 5. Okay. Then one in the council, now, what happened? Arrested the apostles and put them in prison. Okay, because they were just causing, I wanted to use the word causing confusion in the land, but it was a good confusion. Because the Bible says people were becoming obedient to the faith, and the rulers there, they didn't like that. So they arrested them, put them in prison. And guess what happened? At night, an angel of the Lord appeared and opened the prison door and told the apostles, he said, go to the temple and preach the words of life. Now, they were arrested for preaching. An angel of the Lord then came at night, opened the prison door and said, go back to the place where you were and preach the words of life. My goodness. Now, so they arrested them. And so the council met and to talk about these people who are causing trouble for the religious rulers of the day. So when they met and they were discussing, they said, okay, by the way, and so one of the men came and said, the people that we put in prison, they are not there. Actually, they are in the temple preaching the same message. So when they brought them in, Gamaliel said, let these people go out. Give me the next verse, please. 35. And he said to them, men of Israel, take heed to yourselves what you intend to do regarding this man. Verse 36. For some time ago, Theudas rose up, claiming to be somebody. A number of men, about 400, joined his movement. He was slain, and all who obeyed him were scattered and came to nothing. After this man, Judas of Galilee rose up in the days of the census and drew away many people after him. He also perished. In other words, he died, buried, and that was the end of his movement. Scripture says, and all who obeyed him were dispersed. But there is something about this man. And he said, be careful, so that you are not working against God, because if these things be of God, it will stand. But if it's not from God, then it will come to nothing. Now, when the Bible says in Acts chapter 1 verse 8, that you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in all Judea, Samaria, and the end of the earth. Judea, Samaria, and the end of the earth. You shall be my witnesses. Now, a witness is a person who is an eyewitness of an event. Is that not true? Say, for instance, something happened last night, and the police are trying to gather information. And so what they normally do is that they will ask for witnesses. And what they're saying is that we want people who saw what happened to step out and tell them what actually transpired. Is that not true? Now, how do you be a witness of what you didn't see? So, you see, Thomas, who said, I will not believe unless, because the Lord just appeared to them and he wasn't there, and they were excited, oh, we've seen the Lord. He said, okay, you've seen the Lord, but I haven't seen him. And I, Thomas, the Didymus, will not believe until, or unless I see him with my own eyes, and touch him. And Jesus actually came. And when he appeared again, what did he say? He said, Thomas, come. He said, touch. And Thomas touched. And he cried, he said, my Lord and my God. And on account of that encounter with the resurrected Lord, Thomas took the gospel at the risk of his life to India, where he eventually died. Now, how do you put your life on the line for something that is not real and genuine and authentic? You think about that. These were men that were, you know, after his death and burial, they were afraid. They were behind closed doors. But once they saw the Lord and they received the power of the Holy Spirit, they went everywhere preaching the gospel. They couldn't stop them because they saw him. Scripture says in Acts chapter 1, for 40 days, he appeared to them with many signs, infallible proofs, and he was teaching them, talking to them about things pertaining to the kingdom. So they were high witnesses of the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So let's go to 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Let me just run through this very quickly. Number one, the resurrection of Jesus Christ is the foundation of the Christian faith. The resurrection of Jesus Christ is the foundation of our faith. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 12, the Bible says the message we preach is Christ who has been raised from the dead. So how could anyone of you possibly say there is no resurrection of the dead? For if there is no such thing as a resurrection from the dead, then not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, all of our preaching has been for nothing, and your faith is useless. If Christ did not resurrect, all this thing that we're doing is we're just wasting time. Is that not true? And your own faith is useless if Christ did not resurrect. Because there were some people in the days of Paul who were saying there is no resurrection of the dead. That once you die, then that's it. So they said, no. That's actually the hope of believers. The hope of resurrection. Because Christ also rose from the dead. In verse 15 he said, moreover, if the dead are not raised, that would mean that we are false witnesses who are misrepresenting God. If Christ did not rise, did not resurrect, then we are false witnesses. What does that mean? So we're saying, we're reporting what we did not see. We're reporting what is not true. If Christ did not resurrect, that would mean that we are false witnesses who are misrepresenting God. And that would mean that we have preached a lie, stating that God raised him from the dead, if in reality he didn't raise him from the dead. If the dead are not raised up, that would mean that Christ has not been raised up either. And if Christ is not alive, you are still lost in your sins and your faith is a fantasy. Amen. Because there will be no basis for what we claim that we have received from the Lord. It's what that would be a fraudulent practice. You know, if you're preaching what is not true. But he rose from the dead. And so we can boldly say we are God's children on the account of that sacrifice over 2,000 years ago when he hung on that cross. Hallelujah. He's the foundation of our faith. It will also mean that those believers in Christ who have passed away have simply perished and there is no hope of resurrection for them. But that isn't true. What we preach is authentic, is genuine. Our faith is real. There is hope of resurrection. The dead in Christ will rise that on that day. There's another resurrection morning. The dead in Christ will rise. Resurrection of Christ is the foundation of our Christian faith. Number two, his resurrection is the basis for our justification. And the word justification means just as if we never sinned. In Romans chapter 4, verse 25, scripture says that Jesus was handed over to be crucified for the forgiveness of our sins and was raised back to life to prove that he had made us right with God. He died for our sins, for the forgiveness of our sins, and he rose for our justification. That means a right standing with God. If Christ did not resurrect, then we don't have a right standing with God. We are still in our sin. But that's not the case. And that's why we can cry, Abba Father. We can come fearlessly and boldly, confidently before the throne of grace, and we can say, Dad, I have come. You know, this is the struggle. This is what is going on and all of that. And we have confidence that God is hearing us and we expect to do what we're actually discussing with him based on not just the death of Christ, not just his burial, but more than that is resurrection. I've never seen a man who rose from the light, Jesus Christ. And that is why he is Lord. He is Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. He is Lord. Hallelujah. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue confess, oh, that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord. He, make it personal. He is my Lord. Oh, he is my Lord. Amen. He has risen from the dead. Oh, he is my Lord. Oh, hallelujah, every knee shall bow. Oh, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Never seen a man who rose from the dead like Jesus Christ. That is the difference. That is a difference. Because if he did not resurrect, then we might as well just put him in the category of, I don't want to mention other religion, but then that would just be, is that not true? Because they also came and they did amazing work and amazing movement, and they also died. And in fact, as a matter of fact, some of them even did mighty works here on earth. But the difference, that he died, he was buried, and he rose from the dead. Wow, good to see you. Good to see you. You know this mass sometimes, you know. Wow, it's lovely to see you. God bless you. Hallelujah. So in the New King James Version, scripture says, Romans chapter 4, verse 25, who was delivered up because of our offenses, and was raised because of our justification, just as if we never sinned. And you can also boldly declare like Paul, I have kept clear conscience before God and before man. How do you say something like that? Because of the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Christ. You know what that means? That what you did in your past, now that you are a new creature in Christ Jesus, you can say, yes, I have carried clear conscience all along before God and before man because of his blood. Amazing God. His resurrection gives us hope, and it is the foundation for our hope of resurrection. Because we know that when the time comes, that we have to leave this earth. We know that we are going to reign with him because there will be the resurrection of the dead. And so Paul writing, he said, don't mourn, don't cry, don't grieve like those who don't have hope. For us believers, this is not the end. Hallelujah. As a matter of fact, when we step out of this earthly suit, that is the beginning of the real life for us believers because of the hope of resurrection. And that obviously possible because Jesus rose from the dead. So in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 3, scripture says, celebrate with praises the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has shown us his extravagant mercy, for his fountain of mercy has given us a new life. We are reborn to experience a living, energetic hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. A living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. As I close, this hope of resurrection, based on his own resurrection from the dead, it encourages us to live holy life. Because of this hope, because we know that for us, it's not going to end here. Those who died in Christ will resurrect. And because of this hope of resurrection, we are encouraged to live a life of holiness. In 1 John chapter 3 verse 1, scripture says there, 1 to 3, behold what manner of love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. Therefore the world does not know us, because it did not know him. Beloved, now we are children of God, and it has not yet been revealed to us what we shall be. But we know that when he is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And everyone who has this hope in him purifies himself just as he is pure. Because of the hope of resurrection, we are encouraged to live a holy life. This hope of resurrection, number two, encourages us to keep serving God because we know that our labor in him is not in vain. It encourages us to serve the Lord even when we don't feel like, because we know that on that resurrection morning, and when we are all gathered together with Jesus, we are going to be rewarded for what we carried out here on earth. So we keep serving the Lord. We keep giving to the Lord, even when it's difficult to do so, because we know it is not in vain. It is not in vain. It is not worthless. It is not useless. It's an investment for the harvest or return that we're going to step into in eternity. So scripture says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 58, therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Same chapter where Paul obviously addressed the issue of resurrection of the believers on the account of the resurrection of the Lord. If the dead do not rise, then Christ is not risen. And if Christ is not risen, then your faith is futile. You are still in your sins. I want us to spend 2 minutes this morning. And you're going by yourself. Offer thanks to God for the sacrifice. I don't know honestly I personally will be able to, you know, live in a world that is so polluted, contaminated, and is so perverse and all kind of things, just wickedness, evil everywhere. I don't know how I'll be able to manage if not for the hope of resurrection. If not for the hope of eternity. And this is possible because of the sacrifice of his death and resurrection. I don't know about you, but anytime I remember my past life before grace found me, I'm eternally grateful to God. Always in awe of him. And then I can boldly declare that I am justified. What? Yes. Because he rose for that reason. He rose from the dead for my justification. That your blood can be totally wiped and left clean because of the blood he shed on the cross. Amazing grace. Amazing grace. Amazing grace that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Grace. Grace. Ladies and gentlemen, this is what we celebrate today. Resurrection Sunday. We celebrate the price that was paid over 2,000 years ago for the foundation of what we call faith. Praise him in your own way. Give him glory this morning. Say, thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, Ramahande Kuriandala Bashir. And if you're here this morning, maybe in this awe, or maybe watching online, and you have not yet received the gift of salvation. See, that's what this weekend is all about. The gospel is the good news of the provision made by God. And that provision speaks to the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Christ for our salvation and restoration and reconciliation. He paid the price. He's not asking to pay the price. He paid it. And all he's asking you to do is to come to a place where you know that you can't save yourself. You need a savior. You repent from your sin and you put your trust in the finished work of Christ on the cross of Calvary. Believing with your heart and confessing with your mouth, you will be saved. So if you're here today or you're watching online and you want to ask him to come, I want you to take that bold step of faith and say to him, Lord Jesus, I know that I'm a sinner and that you went to the cross, you died for my sin, and you rose on the third day for my justification. I believe the gospel. I believe. And I put my trust in the finished work on the cross. Forgive me my sin. Break the power of sin over my life. Give me the gift of the Holy Spirit. I am yours now. And I receive grace to walk with you to the very end. Grace to endure to the end. I receive in the name of Jesus. And thank him for it. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory for it, Lord. You said those who come to you will not cast away. As many who are saying, Lord Jesus, come into my life, come into my heart. Please save them. Break the power of sin over them, Heavenly Father. Take them by the hand and walk with them and lead them. In Jesus' name. Thank you. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Let's put our hands together for the Lord. Amen and amen. I'm going to ask the choir to please come back and lead us in a time of powerful praise unto our God as we honor the Lord with our substance. I'd like to invite you to please at this time to worship God with your offering. The Lord loves a cheerful giver. Out of the abundance that we have received from the Lord, we have brought little to appreciate God. The Bible says, who has given to the Lord that he should repay him? What have you that you have not received from the Lord? It's a great honor and privilege to be able to worship God, you know, to bring out of what we have received from the Lord to worship our God. He is the giver of every gift that is good and perfect. No man can receive anything except it is given to him from above. So let's give to the Lord this morning, and the Lord will reward you abundantly. So let us pray. Gracious Father, we want to thank you. Thank you for the privilege of not just worshiping with our hands raised. It's an expression of worship. Not just worshiping you by singing. That is amazing, is a form of worship. Not worshiping you only by praying or dancing. Yes, amazing, they are fantastic. They are expressions of worship. But we're grateful for the opportunity to be able to worship with our offering. And so this resurrection morning, as we give to you out of what you have given to us, we pray that you will accept it. You will establish the work of our hands. Please prosper the work of our hands. Rebuke lack permanently in the name of Jesus Christ. We will not just have enough to meet our needs, but we will have more than enough to be able to do good works. Father, for this we give you praise and we give you all the glory. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Please, if you have a gifted number, please don't forget to add your gifted number. The Lord bless you as you give in Jesus' name.
Shall we rise up on our feet?
Hallelujah. Come on, put our hands together. Savior is alive, alive forevermore. The sting of death is gone, and I believe I have eternal life. That Jesus is alive. Everybody say alive, alive, alive. My Savior is alive. One more time to say, alive, alive, alive. My Savior is alive, alive forevermore. The sting of death is gone, and I believe I have eternal life. Jesus is
Now, come on.
He's alive.
Jesus,
Jesus is alive. Hey. Forever he's alive, amen.
Say he's alive, amen. He's alive. Jesus, he's alive. Forever he's alive. Somebody say. Come on now.
He's alive.
I can see you rejoicing.
Jesus, he's alive. Forever he's alive.
Are you not happy that he's alive? Say he's alive. Amen. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. Amen. You say.
He's alive. Amen. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. Amen.
Everybody put your hands together. Come on. Come on now. Hey, clap your hands like you know God. One more time, one more time. Let's just say, I know my Redeemer liveth. I know my Redeemer liveth. I know my Redeemer liveth. He liveth forevermore. You say,
I know my Redeemer liveth.
Hey, hey.
I know my Redeemer liveth.
Oh, oh.
I know my Redeemer liveth.
Say,
he liveth forevermore.
Say, I know my Redeemer liveth. I know my Redeemer liveth. I know my Redeemer liveth. He liveth forever. You said that.
I know my Redeemer liveth. I know my Redeemer liveth.
Oh,
I know my Redeemer liveth.
Say, he liveth
forever.
Say, I love the man of Galilee. You say, for he has done so very much for me. He has forgiven me,
sin. He has forgiven me all my sins and sent the Holy Ghost to me.
I love the man of Galilee. Say, forgiven me and said,
Holy Ghost to me.
I
love the man
of Galilee. One more time. Do you really, really, really love him?
I love the man.
Yes, I do.
Of Galilee.
Oh, Galilee.
He has done so very much for me.
Very much for me.
He has forgiven me of my sin and sent the Holy Ghost to me.
I love the man. I love the man
of Galilee.
I love the man.
I love the man.
Galilee.
Of Galilee.
Oh, oh, oh.
He has done so very much for me.
Very much for me.
He has forgiven me all my sins.
And sent the Holy Ghost
to me. I love the man
of God.
Of Galilee.
I am on the rock. Say, rock that's higher than I. Say, Jehovah, hide me. I am on the road. Go turn my head.
Go turn my enemy.
Say, I am on the road. Jehovah, hide
me.
Hey, I am under the rock.
I am under the
rock that's higher than
I.
Say, Jehovah, hide me.
Hide me.
Hey, I am under the
rock.
Go tell my enemy.
Tell my enemy.
Yeah,
I am under the rock.
Hey,
Jehovah, hide me.
One more time. Even though I am under the
rock. I am under the
rock that's higher than
Jehovah, hide me.
I am under the rock. Go tell my enemy.
Go tell my enemy.
Hey.
I am under the rock.
Jehovah, hide,
Jehovah, hide me.
I am under the rock. Say, Jesus' name so sweet. Emmanuel's name so sweet. Everybody say,
Jesus' name so sweet. Emmanuel's name so sweet.
Jesus' name so sweet.
Emmanuel's name so sweet.
Everybody say
Jesus' name so sweet. Emmanuel's name so sweet.
Say every rock me rock upon Jesus. Jesus' name so sweet. You say
every rock me rock upon Jesus. Jesus' name so sweet.
One more time. Say every rock me rock upon. Rock me rock. Rock me rock. Rock. Every rock me rock. Rock me rock. Rock me rock. Emmy, rock me rock. Rock me rock. Rock me rock.
One more time you say
Emmy, rock me rock upon Jesus' name so sweet. Somebody shout hallelujah. Woo!
Good morning and a happy Easter Sunday. Today is a beautiful day as we look back to the resurrection of Jesus and celebrate God's display of agape love to the world by giving us his only begotten Son. May our heart be continually renewed with hope and our life be full with the life of Jesus by the power of his resurrection. Amen. If you are joining us here and online for the very first time, we welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. If you live in the city of Portsmouth, you are invited to join us in our church building for Sunday service on Sunday at 10 a.m. All our other weekly services and prayer meetings are held online. You can send us inquiry through our church website if you want to find out how to fellowship with us during the week. Our other weekly meetings times are Monday to Friday, 6 a.m. to 6:15 a.m. for Zion's Sake prayer meeting. Tuesday, we have our Bible study from 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. Friday, we have an hour of intercessory prayer and Holy Communion from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. We start our Sunday with Sunday school at 9 a.m. to 9:30 a.m., followed by Sunday service online and on-site from 10 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Children's church is at 12:30 on Sundays. This coming Saturday, 10th of April, it's Mount Zion Hour. This is a prayer of personal supplication from 7 a.m. to 8 a.m. We have prayer chain once every month. Please visit prayerchain.rccgportsmouth.org.uk. If you have any testimony or prayer requests, please send them to info@rccgportsmouth.org.uk. That's all for today. Have a lovely Easter celebration and bask in amazing God's grace. See you next time.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. So we are closing now. But before we pray, do we have anyone worshiping with us for the first time today? It's your first time here. Your very first time here today. Oh, praise God. Please, you mind? Right. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming. We believe strongly that the Lord ordered your step here today, and the Lord who ordered your step here, he will bless you in Jesus' name. Please, after benediction, we'd like to, just for 1 minute, is that okay? All right, God bless you. Gracious Father, we thank you. You are the resurrection and life. Jesus, the risen Lord. The resurrected Christ. Thank you for the price you paid. Thank you for the sacrifice. Thank you for the hope that we have in you. We're grateful for you taking our place in punishment. We're grateful for the exchange that took place on that cross. We're grateful because of your death, we have life. We're grateful. And so we decree and declare, by the word of the Lord and by the Spirit of the living God, that every dry bone shall live again. Amen. Not by power, not by might, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord. Because of the power that raised him, Jesus, from the dead, we know that that power is at work in us. And that quickening spirit will jack back to life that which is dying. It will make straight that which is lame. In the name of Jesus the Christ. Listen. There is nothing you believe God for that God can't do for you. He said only believe. You will see the salvation of the Lord. You know why? Because when he gave Jesus, he gave his best. Scripture says he who did not withhold his son, but offered him up for us all. What is it that he will not freely? So other things are what you call, you know, things that are added freely, because when he offered his son, he gave his best. And so we declare, according to the word of the Lord, concerning that issue, concerning that need, concerning that matter, in this season of resurrection, we pray that God will satisfy the longings of your heart. It will exceed your expectations. You will have joy. Fullness of joy. In the name of Jesus Christ, we speak to that anxious mind. Peace be still in the name of Jesus. Receive quietness in your spirit. Calmness. Rest. The peace of God that surpasses human comprehension, may that peace guard your heart and your mind. Amen. Through Christ Jesus, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. He will help you. Amen. He will assist you. Amen. And with him on your side, you will do valiantly. Amen. This week will be your receiving week. Amen. Lies will fall to you in pleasant places. Amen. You will conquer and conquer. Amen. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. So go in his might, go in his grace, go with his favor. May his abiding presence assure you of his peace, and may all be well with you. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Surely together, the Lord's goodness and mercy, and all the days of our life, forever and ever. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. Happy, happy Easter Sunday. God bless you. God bless you. And Sister Chidima, it's lovely to see you. Lovely to see you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Who taught the sun where to stand in the morning? Who told the ocean you can only come this far? And who showed the morn Where to hide till evening? Whose words alone can catch a furling storm? I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer. Testify this life with me be crying. I know my Redeemer lives. Oh. The very same God that's painting and hope. Runs to the weary, the worn and the weak, and the same gentle hands that holds me when I'm broken, they conquer death to bring me victory. Say, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation testify the life within me cry. I know my Redeemer. I know my Redeemer lives. I know, I know my Redeemer lives. Let all creation, let all creation testify. Lovely.